Mass in the afternoon. And we're looking forward to a wonderful celebration. I know our children have been anticipating this day for a number of months, and it is indeed a day that should be anticipated and looked forward to. I imagine parents too, you should anticipate this day. So this will be a great celebration of the presence of our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament and receiving Him in Holy Communion. I'd like to point out that joining me at the Mass is our new associate, Father Fred Pesek. And Father Fred is a Southwest Sider by birth, St. Nicholas of Valentine, off of 63rd London. So we're very happy to have Father Fred here. And who do you cheer for in baseball?
Let's stand and worship together our opening song, "I Just Came to Praise the Lord." I just came to praise the Lord. I just came to praise the Lord. I just came to praise His holy name. I just came to praise the Lord. I just came to love the Lord.
You were set to heal the contrite heart.
call sinners.
You came to call sinners. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the first reading.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah was afraid and fled for his life, going to Beersheba of Judah. He left his servants there and went a day's journey into the wilderness until he came to a solitary broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death. Enough, Lord, take my life, for I am no better than my ancestors. He lay down and fell asleep under the solitary broom tree. But suddenly, a messenger touched him and said, "Get up and eat." He looked there at his head. Was a hearth, a cake, and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him and said, "Get up and eat, or the journey will be too much for you." He got up, ate, and drank. Then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see. Of the Lord.
reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus Christ, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we have the first book of Kings reading today, the prophet Elisha. He was kind of bummed out about things, but then the Lord came and said, hey, get up and eat. And the Lord gave him a bread cake to eat and water. And that kept him going physically for 40 days till he got to the mountain of God, Horeb. Now, besides the food that we take to sustain our bodies, we also have to sustain our spirit. We have to sustain the spiritual side of us, our soul. And that we nourish through the Eucharist. We nourish it by coming to church, and we nourish it by receiving our Lord in Holy Communion. So that we have a special bread. This is the bread that Jesus gives to us. And it is during Mass that the priest says the same words of Jesus. Take this and eat. This is my body. And it becomes the real presence of Jesus in this bread. And that bread is here to nourish us. Here in the gospel, that I am the living bread, Jesus says, come down from heaven. Who eats this bread will live forever. Because what Jesus gives of us, his bread, is real life, life for eternity. So Jesus had that Last Supper. And at that Last Supper is when he first changed the bread and wine into his body and blood. And he was preparing his disciples that he would be giving up his own body on the cross for us, so that we might have eternal life. So the Eucharist sustains us, nourishes us, and gives us this food for the journey of life, food for our spiritual journey of life. I was talking with someone who had not been to church since March. They've been watching the Mass on TV, but she said that, you know what I really miss, Father? And she had tears in her eyes. And she said, I really miss receiving our Lord in Holy Communion. Receiving our Lord in Holy Communion is what she missed. That's how special the Eucharist was for her. And so she was glad to be in church on a Sunday, where she was able to once again receive our Lord. So, any First Communion, this First Communion, we know it's special for our children. We know that. And we look for it, and they look forward to it. But Communion and the Eucharist and Mass should be special for all of us. That Jesus gave himself to all of us so that we might have life forever. That we might live in him. Now, I'm going to ask our first communicants to please stand, okay? Please stand. And I'm going to want you to pray the first communion prayer up there, okay? And you know what? We're going to have you, but why don't you kneel for this prayer? Because that's what you're saying in the prayer. So our first communicants, kneel, okay? And let's pray together. I fold my hands, then kneel and pray on this, my first communion day. I ask you, Jesus, to watch me grow and teach me all that I need to know. Protect me daily from all things bad and fill my heart with all things glad. And if I ever lose my way, please guide me back when I kneel and pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And now you may be seated, boys and girls. And now as I call the names of our children to receive
Please respond, Lord. The Pope Francis, Cardinal Subic, all the bishops and priests, that they be guided by the Holy Spirit in all their actions and decisions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of all countries consider the welfare of all people in their decision process. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our first communicants realize their importance in the body of Christ.
hope in the silence of your hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. God, our Creator and our friend, hear the prayers we present to you. In your goodness, we ask you to answer them through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
You may be seated.
Sing a new song in adoration, and so with all the host of angels, cried out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna.
peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ. Directions for receiving Holy Communion. First of all, it's going to be the first communicant and his or her parents that will come out of the pew first, as directed by the usher. Okay? And as you come out of your pew, you're going to have your hand sanitized. Okay? Our sanitizers. And then you're going to rub it in really good. Body of Christ. step to the side that you came from, to that next circle, pull down your mask, and look at the altar and crucifix, and receive our Lord and Holy Communion. And then, our parents, if you came from this side, then you're going to go over, and then Father Fred's going to be over here. And our parents will receive from Father Fred. And then when you go back into the pew, there's no need to climb over each other. Just stay on the end, because after our first communicants receive our Lord, everybody else is going to slide down to them. And we're going to be in the same order as we started afterwards, okay? So that is what we're going to do.
Reach us, oh.
First Communicants, stand now, please. Why don't we congratulate them? Now I ask that you remain standing. I know a number of you probably have received sacramentals. Those are holy items, rosaries, or prayer books, or pins, or medals. And I'm going to ask you to hold them in your hand. And I'm going to go down the aisle and bless all of your holy items, your sacramentals. Just a few announcements. A reminder that please wait to be dismissed from your pew as you go outside. Okay? Remember, as you walk towards the path of church, there are some items on the table to be picked up, pictures and whatever. Remember to take your banner with you. It's hanging, anything else that's in the pew. And then you may gather outside. It's not the best of you, but gather outside. So that if you wish to take pictures, you can take as many pictures as you want outside of the beautiful places by our statue of our Blessed Mother. Okay? And Father Fred and I would be happy to take a picture too. Please realize we will be keeping our social distance and wearing a mask. So that's what we will be doing. We have also, as a church, we have two bulletins. We've got this Sunday's bulletin, looks like this, and then we have a bulletin from last week with all the names of the first communicants on it. So it might be a nice memory to take with you. And it doesn't mean, though, that because you've got two bulletins that you went to one church for two times. And just a reminder that we do have Mass. Our Mass is 4 o'clock on Saturday and 9:30 or 11:30 on Sunday. You do have to register online for Mass, as you did for this Holy Communion. You may want to have your child come to church wearing his or her communion attire. Let people know that this child has just made their first communion. So that's something that you may want to consider. And finally, as you do exit the pews, it helps us to get the church sanitized, because we do have 4 o'clock Mass, if you leave your kneelers in the down position. So that way they don't have to push them down. So leave your kneelers in the down position. And once again, Father Fred and I, Father Edgar cannot be with us, we congratulate all our first communicants. Thanks be to God.